गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। लेट मी इंट्रोड्यूस टुडेज रिसोर्स पर्सन। डॉक्टर हरीश एन सर हैज डन हिज डॉक्टरल फिलोसॉफी इन कोस्टल इंजीनियरिंग एंड मास्टर ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी इन मरीन स्ट्रक्चर्स। सर इज करंटली वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ सिविल इंजीनियरिंग नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी गोवा। आई वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट सर टू स्टार्ट द सेशन।
Good morning to all. Thank you for inviting me to present a session on artificial intelligence in a civil engineering. And I would like to thank all the organizers and the committee member who have invited me to give a lecture on this intelligent system to share my research work with you all. And pleasure to share my knowledge with you. Okay. Now can I share my slides?
Yes, sir. I've given you the host privileges. You can share. Fine.
My slides are visible.
Yes, sir.
Good morning to one and all for today's lecture on artificial intelligence in civil engineering. Okay, so before moving with this topic, first we will understand what is this artificial and what is this intelligent. Okay, as a human being, everyone will be intelligent on their own way. So how the intelligence have been developed, that is an important part here. Suppose if you want to, in the basic thing is in your childhood or when you are 1 year or 2 year baby or up to 5 years, your elders will be teaching you some of the shapes which is resembles this object. Okay, for example, they will teach an apple having a circular shape. Okay, you will resemble the apple in the shape of circular, mango in the curved, right? You will be resembling all those shapes with respect to the shapes itself. Your mind will be resembles, means recognize the shapes with respect to circle. And later on, they'll be teaching you numbers or alphabets, right? 1, 2, 3, like that. They'll be teaching, and you'll be resembled. Your brain will store in the shape, in the form of shape, right? Or in the form of numbers. So your intelligence system is already developed at that stage itself. At that stage itself, your intelligence system will be developed. What is this intelligence system means? Suppose after 5 years or 6 years, if you see some object, you will first recognize what is that, means based on the shape, whether it is an object of circular or square or rectangle, all those things you will triangle or trapezoidal recognize, and then you'll resemble that, okay, this is apple or this is mango, right? Same way the intelligence system, the artificial will be working in this, how will this intelligence system work in this, that we'll be discussing. So in the initial stage, what they will do when you're thinking, so they will teach you in such a way that, okay, this is crow will be having a black color. First thing is you identify the shapes, right? Identify the shapes, all those things. Next, later stage, they will be teaching you the birds color. Okay, colors. Then they will be going with different objectives and they'll be start naming all those things. That means some memory will be stored in your brain. Some memory will be stored in a brain in the intelligence system based on the shapes, color, and the shape of the object. Then you'll try to recall that. That means you already learned. How you have learned? You already learned by the elders, how you thought. Based on that, your intelligence system is ready now. So when you grow up, now no one will be with you to teach what is all those things. Directly, when you're talking to your friends or your relatives or neighbors, you'll try to understand or try to reproduce what you all learned when you are a child. Okay, that means your intelligence is already developed and you'll be start working on that. You'll start reproducing that. That means you start predicting that. And obviously, based on your intelligence, definitely it will be accuracy. That means that is the tendency of human nature. Correct. That means these intelligence systems, how to implement in the civil engineering, that we'll be discussing. It is not a new topic. In the past 2 or 3 decades, this has been implemented in civil engineering in a vast way. Okay, now with a brief introduction with this, we'll be moving on to how to apply these intelligence systems for the civil engineering. Okay, now before moving that, what is this artificial intelligence? Artificial intelligence is nothing but it's a simulation of human intelligence in the machines that are programmed to link human and mimic their actions. Okay, first what I told you, the intelligence of the human being, what is intelligent? Then this is been programmed and linked with the machine to mimic the human behavior. That is called as intelligence. How to mimic in the civil engineering as a human, that will be discussed when we move on to the coming slides. Okay, now in the slides, if you look at this slides, there are n number of structures. There are civil structures, bridges, and dams, and this is a port. Okay, these are the structures. Okay, as a civil engineer point of view, the thing is you should understand the fundamental concepts to construct these buildings, right? Fundamental concept to construct this any structure or any problem that is coming. So if you look at this structure, it is a frame structure, right? To analyze this frame structure, first of all, you should know what type of design you have to do. So before designing this structure, the first fundamental thing is you should know the properties of this material that is involved here, right? Steel, concrete. In the concrete, if you consider, there are n number of gradients that is involved in concrete, like fine aggregate, coarse aggregate, right? Cement, water cement ratio, all those ingredients you should understand first, the fundamentals. Then you will be going with the analysis, what type of load that is coming, all those things. That means when you think of this complete structure, it is very complex, right? Very complex in nature. It is very complex in nature because considering all these parameters like fine aggregate, the strength of, what is the strength of fine aggregate, and coarse aggregate, what is the strength, what is the properties of coarse aggregate, cement, water, and mixing all together, what is the reaction that will be taking place, and what is the outcome you are looking for, and when this concrete is binded with steel, then what is the strength that is achieved, and what is the load that can bear there, and what type of structure you will be constructing here, whether it's a residential building or commercial building. So all this will come into a picture first, right? All this will come into a picture and you'll analyze. You'll start analyzing, how to design this structure. Correct, right? So the process that is involved is very complex, right? When you're talking about this building, frame structure. Now, when you're talking about these bridges, again, there will be a moving load. The same thing holds good here. You have to check with the things how to sustain or retain its strength even after applying lot of loads, that moving loads here on the road. Okay, next coming to the dams. Okay, if you coming to the dams here, you have to think about the stability of the dam. Okay, and the storage of the water capacity and the movement of water in between the structures. All those things you have to think and you have to build a structure here. So next is coming to the port. That is when you want to develop a port here, there are a lot of dynamics forces that are applying here, right? That is wave load, wind load, current load, all those things will be coming and hitting the structure. That means there should be some calm condition inside so that the loading and unloading of this berthing has to be done properly. The imports and export of the materials from the outside the world and you have to export to the outside the world. So all these things will be first understood. First you have to understand and then you have to implement that in the field. So with this, as a civil engineers, you have to think in such a way that, so what you will do as a fundamental civil engineers, what do you, first of all, you will understand the material property in the laboratory, right? Everyone will understand the material property in the laboratory, and then you will move on to the design and analysis and you start executing in the field. So when you're talking about the material testing lab, so if you look at the material testing lab, there are n number of testing will be done, like tensile test and tension test of the mild steel and compression test and split tensile, sorry, shear test and hardness of the material. All those things will be doing all in the laboratory. In the geotechnical, if you come, you will be talking about the sieve analysis and the soil properties, like permeability test of the soil, direct shear test. All those things will be done in the geotechnical. And if you coming to the fluid lab, definitely you will be checking about the friction loss, centrifugal pump. So many experiments will be doing in the fluid mechanics labs. And if you come to the structures lab, then if you develop any structure, then what is the maximum load it can withstand and what type of pattern it is failing, all those things will be carried out in the laboratory. Okay, to carry out this laboratory work, what are the things that is involved in your procedure, right? So suppose if you want to check a compressive strength, okay, if you want to check a compressive strength of a concrete, then what is the process that is involved? Simple example, I'll be taking. If you want to check the compressive strength of this concrete, what is the process that is required? So before proceeding with the strength, the first step is you should think what kind of structure you are constructing and what is the grade of concrete that is required. So suppose example, if you are going with M20 grade of concrete, which is for the residential building, then the process will begin here. So once you start, what is the water cement ratio? Then what is the quantity of fine aggregate that is required? Then what is the quantity of coarse aggregate that is required? Then what any admixtures is required here? Admixtures has to be added here. Then you have to mix it thoroughly. You have to mix it all these ingredients thoroughly, and you have to be prepare a mold, and you have to compact in the mold, right? So it will take one day to do all those process, right? One day or half a day. That means you are investing a time there. You are investing a time and you are investing a labors, everything here, right? Then later on, you will be, after 24 hours, you will be put it in a water for curing purpose. Then you will wait for almost 7 to 28 days. So every 3 days, first you will take for 3 days strength, 7 days strength, 15 days strength, and 28 days strength. So to completely process and to say that, okay, this mix can be used as M20 grade in the field, it will take almost 1 month. See the time period to complete this process. What is the time period that is taken? Almost 1 month. So this is the process, normal process. If you want to do all those things, whether the achieved strength is of 120 M20 grade or not. If not, then what you will do? Again, you will change these parameters, and again, you have to wait for 20 days. That means a tedious process, and the labor investment and the cost investment on this is very huge here. Okay. Similarly, if you consider all the laboratories, it is a time consuming and also a lot of investment is required. But in the previous, if you look at in your colleges itself, if you are a professors or if you are a students community or any research community, if you look at in when you are start studying your graduation or diploma courses, there are, you will be doing lot of experiments in the laboratory, right? You will be doing lot of doing experiments in the laboratory, and as your final year projects, you will be working out lot of experimental work, right? And you will be collecting lot of data, right? Lot of data will be collecting. Where the data gone? What is the use of that data? You have invested lot of things, right? A lot of time and money to collect, to do the experiment and to collect the data, right? So what is the outcome of that? Only thing is, you will suggest that, yes, M20 grade concrete, you have to use so and so mix. Suppose if you are going for the geotechnical, some grade analysis or permeability, some data will be collected and you'll be keeping ready. What is the use of that data? Anyway, the data is available and it will be only in the record books. There is no usage of that, right? And you will be moving out. Again, the next batch comes, you will be doing same process, either M20, they will move out to M35 or M40. They will collect some experimental data and you will get the results. That data only will keep it in a book and you will be moving out. So what is the use of that? That means all the data in the laboratories is collected as a similar data. If you look at and open your past 5 or 10 decades of your engineering or field, and if you look at that, open the data, you will get n number of data. That means the data is as per your college standard, as per the college standards and the equipments that you have used, the data will be definitely will be accurate with plus or minus 5 or 10% error in that. And that is due to the manual error or due to experimental error. But anyway, you will be having that data. What is the use of data? What you will be doing that data? Only investment to get that. Then what is the further? Can we use that data in future? That is a question. Can we use that data in the, for the future? And from that basic data, can we use to predict? See, in the initial stage, I already told about the intelligence systems of the human being. How the human beings are learned? Right? I already explained. So based on that intelligence, can we use this data and try to mimic? See, how human beings mimic every time. Everyone will not teach the human being that this is a crow or this is a parrot or this is a peacock or this is a animals that is lion, deer. No one. In the initial stage, they are trained and they are left. After that, continuously, they will learn by themselves and they'll try to predict based on the past experience or past intelligence, right? So can we use this data for the future? Yes, that is possible. That is where we will be using these intelligence systems in this civil engineering. So what is this intelligence systems? Intelligence systems are nothing but the soft computing techniques. Intelligence systems are nothing but soft computing techniques. It's a branch of computer science which tries to build an intelligent and sophisticated machine. See, it will try to build an intelligent and sophisticated machine. Suppose if you take a sophisticated machine, means if you look at the washing machine, that will be using a fuzzy logic. See, every household will be having, nowadays will be having a washing machine, right? That will be using the intelligence systems. What type of, how much water is started to be added? See, in the, when you're using the washing machine, if you look at that, everything will be dumped in a separate places. Water will be coming from separate input and you are putting a cloths and you'll be putting a washing powder in the separate cabin unit in the washing machine. But there, how it will work? Based on the capacity of the cloths, number of cloths, and what is the amount required for that. Obviously, it will take and it will get off. Sufficient water is required. And amount of powder that you have put it in the container, that also will be take automatically. There, the human intervention is very less. Only you will switch on and you will move out. Right? You will switch on and you will move out. After 2 hours or 3 hours, you will come back and you will remove the cloth and you will put it for the sun dry for half an hour or 1 hour. So how this complete mechanism works in the washing machine? See, that means you have adopted some intelligence, human kind of intelligence, that is the mimic of humans in the machines, right? That is what we want to do, the same intelligence systems for the civil engineers. So that is what we are looking for. And what is the soft computing? What is intelligence? It's a fusion of methodology designed to model and enables the solution to the real world problems. Correct, right? When we are taking the example of washing machine, what is done? The final outcome for us is to remove the dirt in the cloths and to make it dry. That is what we want. The same thing, which is very complex, how it will work, all those things, the investment of the human being. But the same thing is done by the machine which you are developed from your intelligence, right? And which is not, and if you consider, which is not modeled and difficult to model mathematically, right? Of course, right? If you take an example to model mathematical model, all those things very difficult, right? But it is working. But it is working efficiently and giving a final output, which is